Welcome back to my course. This is industrial biotechnology. If you look at this flow diagram, the most effective way of communicating the information about a process is through the use of flow diagram. Flow diagram may be a block flow diagram, process flow diagram, piping, and instrumentation diagram. Let me explain that what is the purpose of the flow diagram. In the industry, biochemical industry, they doesn't have only the fermenters. It has the upstream processes, it has downstream processes. Upstream processes, we have pre-treatment of the raw materials, then we have air sterilization, we have medium sterilization. Then you have the fermenter. After fermentation, you have to go for the purification of the product. So, the different steps are involved for the purification of the product, because we should remember that whenever we do marketing of any kind of product, it should be marketed in a purified form. I can give a very simple example. If you look at the catalog of the any chemical catalog, we will come across two type of chemicals. One is analytical grade, another is commercial grade. Now, commercial grade, usually it is about 90%, 95% purity, and analytical grade about 99.99% purity. So, you know, if you see the cost difference between the analytical grade and the commercial grade, the huge difference, maybe 4 times as compared to the commercial grade. So, you know, purification is a very important part that of any chemical and biochemical industry. So main purpose of the flow diagram, just to give you the information, what are the different units that are involved in this particular process to get the product. So that is, and this can be explained in as I told you, in 3 ways. One is block flow diagram, process flow diagram, then piping and instrumentation diagram. Let us see how we can do that. Now, the block flow diagram is a drawing of a chemical and biochemical processes used to simplify and understand the basic structure of the system. The block flow diagram is the simplest form of the flow diagram used in the industry. Blocks in a block flow diagram can represent anything from a single piece of equipment to an entire plant. So, what does it mean? That is, you know, every process we explain as a block, because, you know, in case of block flow diagram, as for example, suppose we consider air sterilization, this should be a particular block. Medium sterilization, it should be a block. So, you know, a fermenter is a block. Then you have separation of the micro cell mass from the fermentation broth, that will be block. So, you know, all the processes we explained with the help of a block. So, it is the simplest way we explain the process. So, this is the what you call block flow diagram. Now, here I have taken the example of the citric acid production industry. In the citric acid industry, you see, after the citric acid production take place in the fermenters, it passed through the different units. Can you see it? This is calcium citrate precipitation unit, filtration and washing, then regeneration of citric acid, again filtration, decoloring, again filtration, concentration, crystallization, centrifugation, drying, sieving, and packing. So, you know, there are so many steps involved before we get the final products, and every step we explain with the help of a block. Like, you know, this is a fermented liquor we collected after the rotary, after separation of the microbial cells, we get the filtrate, and this filtrate we treat with lime to precipitate out the citric acid in the form of calcium citrate. Then this calcium citrate is the insoluble mass that is to be separated with the help of filtration process. Then you wash this filter, that is this calcium citrate, so that, you know, the color that it partly can be removed. Then this is hydrolyzed in presence of H2SO4. Again, then it converts the calcium citrate to citric acid and calcium sulfate. Then calcium sulfate is removed in the form by, this is called gypsum for disposal, and filtered, you use some kind of decoloring matter like activated carbon to remove the color, because other, if color is present in your product, then it will be very difficult to market the product. Then you have to do the filtration, you have to remove the activated carbon, then you have to concentrate with the help of evaporator, then after that you cool it down, then you pass through the crystallization unit to form the crystals of citric acid, then you centrifuge this, after centrifugation you separate the crystals, dry it, and sieving it, you get this different size of crystals and packing it. So, you know, this is how the block flow diagram can be explained. Now, let me tell you something about the process flow diagram. The process flow diagram provides a visual representation of the step in a process. So, you can, from the process flow diagram, you can visualize what is that process. Because in the block flow diagram, you cannot visualize the process. You cannot imagine that how the process looks. But every process has some symbol. So, you know, that symbol we shall have to use in the process flow diagram. The process flow diagram provides a visual representation of the steps in a process, and flow diagrams are also referred to as process mapping. It has the following benefits: gives everyone a clear understanding of the process, helps to identify non-value added operations, and facilitates the teamwork and communications, and keep everyone on the same page. So, that is the all information we want to keep in the same page. That is the very important of process flow diagram. By seeing that, you can easily find out that what is going on in the whole plant. You know, that is very important as far any kind of industry is concerned. Now, the process flow diagram is a diagram commonly used in process engineering to indicate the general flow of the plant process and equipment. Process flow diagram displays the relationship of major equipment of a plant facility and does not show minor details such as piping details and designation. It doesn't give the detailed information how the flow, different flow is taking place. Just we have one flow line that indicate how product, how the material flow from one unit to other unit. That is exactly what we have. Another common used term of process flow diagram is the flow sheet. Now, as I told you that the different processes has different units. So, it has the different symbols actually, because we shall have to use that. Then and only then we can easily find out what is that. As for example, this symbol we consider as the heat exchanger, this symbol is considered as the water cooler, this symbol is considered as a steam heater, this type of symbol is considered as a cooling oil, this is considered as a heater coil, this is the centrifugal pump, this is considered as a turbine type compressor, this is considered as a pressure gauge, then this is considered as a stripper. Is you know, the separator unit that commonly to liquid mixture into the gas phase. So, you know, the stripper that we have, then we have absorber, that can be explained like this. Absorber, it looks like this, and stripper looks like this. Now, only the difference is that in case of absorber, we put the liquid in like this, and here in the stripper we put the liquid from the top. That is the difference that we have. Then this is the distillation column, largely used in the alcohol making industry, ethanol fermentation process we use the distillation. So, this is the fractional distillation through which at different temperatures you can separate out different fractions, and liquid mixer that, you know, tank can be represented by this. Then this is the reactor chambers. The reaction chambers can be represented like this. Horizontal tank and cylinder can be represented like this. Boiler can be represented like this. Centrifuge can be represented like this. And different valves, which is very much required for the operation of the industry: gate valve, globe valve, ball valve, check valve, butterfly valve. But I want to point out here, I shall show you the what is the exactly how it looks, the ball bulb. Ball bulb is largely used in the biochemical industry to draw the sample. Because what is the speciality of the ball bulb as compared to globe bulb and gate bulb? Gate bulb, you can slowly increase. You can in the Bosch machine, the bulb that we use, that is the globe bulb. And what is that? You have to slowly open and slowly close. In the industry, we cannot do that. In the fermenter, if you open like this and draw the sample and then close it, by that time, lot of media or lot of sample can spread here and there. So what you have to do is instantaneously you have to open, instantaneously you have to close this bulb. And for that, we find that ball bulb is very good. Ball bulb is, I just show you how it operates. Then relief bulb, needle bulb, three-way bulb, and this is the three-way bulb. You can see it can come here, it can go this way and this way. Then angle bulb is there, butterfly bulb also lot of use in the industry. Now let me give the example of one process flow diagram so that your idea will be little bit clear. This is regarding the ethanol fermentation process from corn starch. So corn is a strover that usually come by truck and is unloaded here, and after unloading you do the grinding, and then this is the conveyor belt. You can see how conveyor belts can be this is not a block flow diagram, this is process flow diagram. You can see that this is the conveyor belt, and then it passes through the pretreatment unit that can be here we pass some steam and acid so that some kind of hydrolysis will take place. Then solid liquid separation unit that we have here, and take the liquid out with the lime, we adjust the pH. Then we take this in the saccharification process for fermentation. We put the enzymes or your microorganisms here to have the ethanol fermentation. Then we heat it, we pass through this, heat it and pass through the distillation column, and we find here the wastewater comes out. And we do this, you see the activated sludge process. We have surface aerator. You can see that how the surface aerator they have defected. And then alcohol, you from the top you can separate out the ethanol. Ethanol you separate out, and some solid material you can take it out here, and you can use for running the boilers. See that the heating for boiler for generate that steam. So this is the one typical example of process flow diagram, how the corn starch can be converted to ethanol. Now piping and instrumentation diagram, a piping or instrumentation diagram and drawing is a detailed diagram in the process industry that shows the piping and vessel in the process flow together with the instrumentation and control device. So this piping and instrumentation diagram that is usually located in the control room of the any fermentation industry. There you can find out that how the plant is how the liquid is flowing from one end to others, what are the different valves is opens, what are the different pumps are functioning, so all this the information will be available. And this is also very what you call PNID diagram. This is very much essential for running an industry, because here I want to point out one thing, that industry we have lot of noise, because when you work with the industry lot of pumps, and because I have given the example that I work with citric acid industry and we have 200 cubic meter reactor, then and 200 that HP motor is using for running, that power is using for operating the agitator. So tremendous noise is there, you know that. So you know that this control panel PID is usually located in the control room. So this is so you can do your analysis very nicely here. The primary and schematic drawing used for laying out a process control control installation. This is very important. Let me give you some idea that what are the utilities of the fermentation industries we have. We have different pumps. A pump is a device that moves the fluid, liquid or gas, sometimes slurries by mechanical action. The we use for domestic, commercial, industrial, agricultural service, the municipal water, wastewater service. Pumps can be classified two major types according to the principles by which the energy is added to the fluid. Now, pumps may be of two types. One is positive displacement pump and dynamic pump. And positive displacement pump again divided into two. With the reciprocating pump, we have diaphragm piston, I shall show you. Then rotary pump, we have peristaltic pump, gear pump and screw pump. This is a rotary pump, low pump and then. Now gear pump, I typically want to mention here, this gear pump is largely used for transferring the viscous liquid, because particularly when in the citric acid industry, in the ethanol making industry, we use the cane molasses as a raw materials for the production of ethanol and citric acid, and this cane molasses is a viscous liquid, so ordinary pump cannot work. This we use the gear pump for the transferring the liquid from the molasses storage tank to molasses measuring tank, which is located in the fermentation plant. So the dynamic, we have centrifugal pump, propeller and turbine. Now positive displacement pump, that positive displacement pump applied pressure directly to the liquid by reciprocating piston or by rotating the chamber. Users can handle the shear sensitive liquid, use high pressure. This is very important. Suppose we want to have the high pressure, then we should go for the positive displacement pump. Use of variable viscosity applications that can be used. The types are reciprocating and rotary. Now, here is the reciprocating pump. Reciprocating pump, the chambers is a stationary chamber that contains a piston or plunger and type of diaphragm and piston. You can see this is rotating, this is the piston is rotating and this is the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm, since the diaphragm is it moving like this, the liquid is going like this, is forced like this. The beauty of this, that you know that your liquid will not come in contact with the directly to the pump. It is just with the membrane. It is coming with the this membrane, that diaphragm is contact, is nothing directly connected with the outside of the this piston and other things. This is how it looks, it liquid flow like this. Now this rotary pump is largely used in the biochemical industry. Rotary pump is the chamber moving inlet to discharge and back to the inlet. Now here I can take the typical example of the peristaltic pump, largely used in the fermentation industry, because this is the silicon tube. Silicon tube is little bit flexible tube. Now you can see that when this shaft is rotated like this, this roller rotates, then it drag the liquid here to this way. Can you see it? That it drag the liquid from one end to other. So this is how, and you know, when you do this, all the material will remain inside the pipeline, inside the tubes. So no way the air will come in contact with this liquid. So sterility of the system is 100% can be maintained. Now I was talking about the gear pump for transferring this cane molasses. So this is the gear pump. This is, we can see this is the gear, how it looks, and with the help of this the inlet and the outlet, when it moves then like this, then it takes the liquid out of there, and this is a viscous liquid we can use very much. Now dynamic pumps are the type of velocity pump in which the kinetic energy is added to the fluid by increasing the fluid flow velocity. Typical types are the centrifugal pump, propeller and turbine. Centrifugal pump is largely used in the day-to-day requirement, in our household requirement also, in the multi-story building particularly we have seen that a centrifugal pump is required to drag the water from the ground level to the top floor tank, the water tank. This is largely used. So I said, so you, this is the operation of the centrifugal pump. You can see how the liquid they're pumping. This is the drag the liquid out and it's going like this. The pump generates the high rotational velocity that converts the resulting kinetic energy of the liquid to pressure energy. So users, the centrifugal pump generally use where the high flow rates or moderate heat required, moderate heat increases are required, can handle the fluid containing the suspended solid. This is how it looks. Now, besides that, there are different valves we used in the fermentation industries. That is very important. The valve is a device that regulate or direct or control the flow of the fluid, the gas, liquid, the fluidized solid or slurry, by opening and closing or partially obstructing the various passageways. The valves can be operated manually, pneumatic pressure and the motor, based on the valve component, body, bonnet, trim, packing and actuator, that you know, that different portion that has been showing here, that you know, how the pumps looks like this. Now, what is the classification of pump? That according to the motion of the valve stem, it can be classified into two types. Control valves, you have linear motion and the rotary motion. Now, in case of linear motion, we have globe valve, we have diaphragm valve, we have gate valve. Now, in globe valve, we have two types. We have single port and double port. Again, we have angle and three ways. But when you come to the rotary motion, we have ball valve, we have butterfly valve and disc valve. This is largely used in the biochemical industry for drawing the sample. And gate valve is largely used for the harvesting purpose. After the fermentation is over, the whole fermentation broth, we take it out through this opening the gate valve. Now, the globe valve, how it looks, let me show you that. Globe valve restricts the flow of fluid by altering the distance between a movable block and the stationary set. So, you can see this is the liquid is coming and passing through this orifice is going like this. So, when you open this, this shaft will go up, the liquid will flow like this. And when you close it, this slowly it will close this, so you know water will flow to take place. This is how globe valve, this is we use in our house, in the particularly in the water basin, we use this because for controlling the flow rate of the water. Now, diaphragm valve is like this. This is a diaphragm. This is a so when it comes, it touches this here, so that the flow rate will be arrested. The diaphragm valve is a flexible. This is a flexible seat. This is a rubber type of material, passed and closed to the edge of the solid dam to narrow the flow path of the fluid. And this is really perfectly. This is used to prove to have a leakage proof, because you know, since it is flexible, it doesn't have much of leakage inside the system. This valve is well suited for flow containing the solid particulate matter such as slurry. It is largely used for that. The utilities, the utilities of the reactor is the gate valve. I told this is used for in the harvesting line. The gate valve works by inserting a dam gate into the path of the flow to restrict in a manner that similar to the action of the sliding door. So it is just like a sliding door. What is happening in the sliding door, that if you open it, everything is open, and close it, everything is open. So here in this valve also, you can see when it is coming down, it is totally closed, and when it is open, it opened totally. So that you know, when liquid is flowing through, there should not be any kind of hindrance to the flow of the liquid. No friction, no hindrance will be there. The all liquid will go out like this. Gate valves are more often used on and off control than throttling. This cannot be used for throttling. This is just on and off. It automatically goes out like this. There should not be any friction that takes place here. Now, ball bulb, I was talking about the ball bulb for using for sampling purpose. The spherical bulb with a passageway cut through the center rotates to allow the fluid more or less access to the passageway. It can be used for sample collection. Let me explain that. That you can see, this is the bulb, this is ball, you know, this is circular things. So when you rotate, it will close this whole part. This is the handle. If you do it like this, then it will close. This is the opening. You can see this is the opening inside. This is the opening that we have, and this is the bulb that we have. So when it comes to the pipeline, the liquid will flow. When this side will go in this pipeline, then the flow will be arrested. So this can be instantaneously you can close, and instantaneously you can open. This is used for sampling purpose. Same, this is for butterfly valve. You can see that you can instantaneously open, instantaneously close. That can be used. Then we have disc valve. This is also similar nature. The needle valve. You can see that we put a needle here. This is for minute control. You use this is needle valve. Then safety valve. That you know. I told you that safety valve, this spring, you can see there is a spring that gives a pressure here. As the pressure increases, it can withstand certain pressure. If it is above this process, then the spring will go up and pressure will be released. The safety valve opens slowly as the pressure increases about the set point and only open as necessary. So this is how the safety valve looks. Besides that, two other pumps I want to point out that is largely used in the chemical and biochemical industry. This is one is the solenoid valve. Solenoid valve is the electromechanically operated valve because it is electrically operated. So if we want to control the things electrically with the help of some kind of device, control device, then we shall have to use the solenoid valve. Manual valve you cannot operate electrically. So solenoid valve, that is why it is largely used by the industry. As for example, suppose you want to monitor that air flow rate and or you know that other that suppose I told you that in the industry that as the anti-foam sensor is there, as soon as the foam touches this, then it energizes it will connected with this your valve is connected so that it is open and it will draw the liquid inside the fermenter. So you know that automatically control it is largely used. In case of three port, it can have two port, it can have three port, as per the it can have many fold also. So it has a different purpose. And another is the pneumatic valve. Pneumatic valve is controlled with the help of pressure. The study of pneumatic deals with the system operate with air and gaseous media to impact power or control power. The term pneumatic is derived from Greek word pneuma, meaning the wind or breath. Pneumatic power is the power that is transmitted to pressurize the compressed air. So you know that on the basis of pressure, we can regulate the valve. If we increase the pressure, we can close the valve and open the valve like this with the help of pneumatic valve. So this is all about the different flow diagrams and the utilities that we use in the fermentation industries. In the next class, we are going to discuss about the upstream processing of the fermentation end. Thank you very much.